Thank you. First of all, I think we have an obvious problem here in that we don't have enough people getting involved in these apprenticeships programs, what I'll call skills-based education. Part of it is attitude of parents. A lot of it, I think, is quite frankly, bad advice from school counselors. Do you have any general suggestions? And as a result, we have way too many people getting degrees that are not of value to them or starting down the path of degrees that aren't going to be valuable to them when they drop out. And in addition to getting a degree that's not increasing their earning potential a lot, frequently they have a lot of student debt to boot. What can we do to get around these attitude problems, get around sometimes bad advice people are getting from their schools?
Representative, I thank you for your question. As I mentioned earlier, I think the way that I can address that or at least start to deal with that issue is by working with the Department of Education, working with their elementary and secondary education office that's responsible for K through 12 education across the country, and making sure that they understand the vital role that they play in workforce. And when I talk about workforce, I talk about the broader workforce, not just ETA's workforce, but the broader workforce. And how does the education system play into that? And how are they preparing students upon graduation to enter the workforce?
Can we specifically talk about salary or wage compensation or number of job openings? Is that something you could make available to the public?
Absolutely. And we've talked not only about the 7.1 million open jobs, but the other number that keeps me awake at night are the 34 million Americans who aren't part of the labor force, not just the unemployment rate, but the forgotten men and women of the workforce.
We've also had even people of this committee talk about getting a college degree like it's somehow superior to getting an apprenticeship, when from what I can see, there's a lot more necessity and for maintenance people, for people in manufacturing. So it kind of offends me when people imply like somehow they've accomplished something better than apprenticeship. And we have people talk that way here. Is there anything specific we can do to prevent that attitude from spreading? I mean, given that we do have people, including congressmen, who kind of talk that way, do you have any other suggestions how we can change the attitude?
Again, I think hearings such as this where we shine a spotlight on the success of the apprenticeship model and what it means. And when we talk about 94% retention rate and we talk about $70,000 starting salary, those are real world numbers. And that does not include the assumption of any debt. So individuals who are entering the workforce through an apprenticeship program, $70,000 debt free. We need to make sure that individuals understand that apprenticeship is a viable option, that it is one of those multiple pathways that we talked about.